More than 1,000 people have been arrested across Russia for protesting against Vladimir Putin's mobilisation of troops into Ukraine. Residents are fleeing the country in droves, while our foreign minister has joined world leaders in condemnation.
Daring to show defiance. Unwilling to stay silent. Russians angry over their president's war in Ukraine take on police in the streets of Moscow. Heavily armed officers with batons brutally dealing with crowds. Protesting can carry a 15-year jail sentence. Yet bold activists stood together chanting Putin to the trenches. There's simmering dissent spilling over following Putin's first televised address since the start of the invasion, where he ordered the conscription of 300,000 reservists to boost his faltering ground forces, the first mobilisation since World War II. Putin accusing the West of nuclear blackmail and warning he has the weaponry to respond, adding he's not bluffing. The mobilisation sparking an immediate exodus. Long queues at border checkpoints. Carloads of Russians trying to flee. Flights out of the capital selling out.
I will have problem in my country. But I want to say freedom for Ukraine.
Others willing to go into battle.
Говорит мне то, что я могу там умереть.
I'm still young, of course, this man says. The pride inside me says, yes, go to war. It attracted swift condemnation from world leaders. US President Joe Biden re-scripting his scheduled address to the UN General Assembly.
This war is about extinguishing Ukraine's right to exist as a state, plain and simple.
Putin's threats follow successful counter-efforts by Ukrainian forces in recent days, pushing back invading troops and regaining Russian-occupied territory in Ukraine's northeast. Ukraine's president urging the United Nations to punish Russia for its aggression.
We didn't provoke this war. We held 88 rounds of talks in various formats to prevent this war.
These threats are unthinkable and they are irresponsible. Russia alone is responsible for this illegal and immoral war, and peace must first lie with Russia withdrawing.
Nearby countries now on high alert. Lithuania's defence minister raising its military's alert level to prevent any provocation from Russia. The UK defence secretary calling Putin's move an admission his invasion is failing, and no amount of propaganda can hide the fact Ukraine is winning this war. A war of words intensifying.
Nuclear war is becoming more and more close to our families, to our houses.
The world hoping it's only words. In London, Edward Godfrey, Nine News.
US correspondent Jonathan Kersley is at the UN headquarters in New York. Jono, the task ahead, how will the General Assembly respond to Putin's move?
Well, that's the big question, Georgie. Vladimir Putin says he's not bluffing, but the world leaders who've been gathered here at the United Nations this week will be hoping that he is. But that's the problem. It is hope. NATO and its allies are dealing with an unpredictable dictator who has threatened the use of nuclear weapons. And now the talk is of war, not just with Ukraine, but with the West. It's clear inside Russia that Vladimir Putin is facing growing opposition to the war. That is crucial. But it is also of concern because it could potentially make him more dangerous and more volatile. And that would be a problem for any leader who's been here pleading for peace. The West has to try and find a way to work as a collective to try and prevent a catastrophe from a president who's becoming a pariah. Georgie.
Jonathan Kersley, thank you.